more Virgo babies. Let's get into this energy for you. Today is the 888 portal. So I hope you guys are using that energy to your advantage. I'm sure there's a lot of videos on that, so tap in. But Virgo, let's get into your messages. Hold on, you guys. I can't have this smoke in my face. All right, Virgo. For Virgo, please. Let's get right into it. You got sleep on it. All right. So is there a decision around something to where you need to meditate and contemplate on it? Tap in with your higher self on something? Okay. So, no quick decisions at this time, Virgo. Something you need to sleep on. Right here, I see this is bullshit with this Kali energy. Something that may seem a little irritating and chaotic. Okay, some defensiveness here from either you or someone you're dealing with. Like a lot of people, there's a lot of hands down here. A lot of hands in the pot. A lot of people with opinions. They're telling you sleep on it. This card is saying sleep on it. Tap into your higher self. You'll make the right decision. All of these hands, all of these opinions, you can filter through them. But the decision is on you. Take your time when making this decision. This energy, this decision may have you feeling a little ungrounded or chaotic. So sleep on it. Take your time. May have you feeling like you can only count on yourself, okay? And you're moving away from a lot of energies that are undependable. Yeah, I think I said that right. Or unreliable. Child. She needs it like that. Party in your heart. All right. So this is telling you not to lose the joy. Not to take things so seriously. To still keep the joy in your heart, my Virgo babies. That's a must. But yeah, there's a need to sleep on something. There's a decision or something, some type of energy where you feel like it's all on me. I can truly only count on myself and my moves. So I don't understand, yet I'm a genius. And you guys are ruled by Mercury, so you guys will figure this out. Okay, this all these equations here, if you can see that, surrounding him. He's really in think mode. Seems like there's a lot of factors to work out. And again, sleep on it. Take your time to figure this out. You definitely will do so. Virgo. Yeah, this is sticking out to me. Like, I can only count on myself. You see, like, he's carrying all these boxes, all these loads, and this chick right here is just on the couch living her best life on the gram or wherever the hell she's scrolling through. Okay, don't let this make you have a heavy heart. Really try to keep that joy in your heart. Try to be lighthearted about the situation. You will figure this out. Now, a word of advice. I wish I could see this. Maybe I should change the lighting here. Well, it says stop repeating the same thing again. I did pick up, it's not gonna be for everyone, someone that's a musician. It's like, stop putting out the same type of style, the same type of music. You may wanna try something else. But in general, not getting too specific, how you can make this decision, what will help you is not doing things in the same way. Don't repeat the same pattern. You're going to get the same outcome. So doing something the same way would be the wrong decision. I don't want to say wrong, but you get what I'm saying. Not the best decision for you. All right. So yeah, fall down on the couch. She just literally just collapsed on the couch. This energy of you need to rest right now. Contemplate on it, meditate on it. Don't let it burden you. Take your time with it. Have some Zen time and then come back to the situation, whatever it may be. Take a time to recharge and really contemplate and meditate on it. I am always a child. All right. This fell under party in your heart. So literally still keeping that high vibration, still keeping that joy through this situation. You will figure this out. Okay. That you are, it says you are a genius. It's just something that you're not grasping right now, because it may be a decision that may change something in your life or affect the life of others. Okay, you just want to make the right decision. So sleep on it, take your time on it. Whatever time that you have to contemplate on it. Just don't repeat the same decision. I said I am always a child, so some of you guys feel like you are the most responsible person in your atmosphere, in your energy. Everybody else is just not focused. It's just like always party, party, party time for them. But definitely, it's telling you, hey, just put down responsibilities for a moment if you can, and just be lighthearted about something. Answers are gonna come to you, and you're most definitely going to figure something out. Having to make this decision, or you overthinking something, is wearing down on you mentally. You're mentally drained. And for some of you guys, physically. For some of you guys with this, no. And stop repeating the same thing again. This is literally telling people no. It's like blocking. That no, I cannot do this for you today. No, I can't do it for you tomorrow. I can't do it for you next week. I'm recharging. I'm focusing on me right now. I might collapse on the couch and literally put my phone on do not disturb. Okay, so take some time to think about some things. Stop repeating the same mistake or repeating the same thing by letting people give you too much burden, too much responsibilities, too many tasks that just don't belong to you. Like, they have the capability to do it they damn selves. But they know good old dependable Virgo is going to come through, figure it out, and take care of everything. So, not allowing that. Okay, so do not disturb. Yep, regeneration in progress. This is what some of you guys are being recommended to do. Pedicure, pamper day. Okay. Put phones on do not disturb. I don't care if somebody shows up at your damn door, ringing the doorbell. You look at them like, hmm. And proceed with Netflix and chill, or your regeneration day. Literally, it's called for right now. It's called for right now. You're being told there is no rush to sleep on this, recover at this time. Do not disturb. Regeneration in progress. Under that, better alone than in bad company. And there's a lot of conflict going on in this card. So, a little solitude time right now, Virgo. A little solitude time where you can go over things, where you can think about your next moves. Think about this specific situation or decision you have to make. downtime, contemplation, meditation. Right now is required on that. It's required. Okay. For Virgo, please. This is for Virgo. Collecting the Virgo, please. I have my calendar on a certain date. And if you see me staring over here, just randomly the page just flipped to this date, 8-5. So 85-58 may be of significance, August 5th. May 8th, that number combination in general. But I'll read it. If you comprehend it, if it hits for you, it's for you. So love is something like the clouds that were in the sky before the sun came out. You cannot touch the clouds, you know, but you feel the rain and know how glad the flowers and the thirsty earth are to have it after a hot day. You cannot touch love either, but you feel the sweetness that it pours into everything. And that was an American educator noted as Helen Keller's teacher. Okay, so this was written by Annie Sullivan. Put it where it fits. Okay, so I just saw exit strategies. So some of you, this is contemplation and meditation and figuring out an exit strategy around some area. For Virgo, please. Collect my Virgo. For Virgo, please. Okay. So we have that flipped over, evil eye. Some of you guys trying to figure out someone and their intentions. Evil eye. The evil eye can be given intentionally or unknowingly. The evil eye, I'm sorry, to evade evil eyes, try not to boast about your success, but act modestly. Use an evil eye amulet to reflect the evil glare back. Some of you guys need to get an evil eye amulet or even this symbol here. Okay, to deflect the evil eye. So, you may not even, you know who this is coming from or be focused on that, but someone may be jealous of your success or just jealous of you in general, throwing you the evil eye. So protect yourself spiritually. You can go through my playlist for that to see how to create spiritual baths, how to work with certain herbs to do so, and the Psalms as well. I think I might do another video on the Psalms. Okay, and if this is you throwing the evil eye at somebody, yeah, whatever, put it where it fits. Okay. It says the evil eye can be given intentionally or unknowingly. So you might be throwing somebody the evil eye because you feel like they're just putting a burden on you. Like, I don't know. So we have stay committed. Your goals. Stay committed. Your goals may feel so far away that they seem absolutely impossible. Accept the good, the bad, and the in-between times. Sometimes success takes a little longer to achieve. Saying this is no rush. Keep going, but at this time, this is a moment. This is a season of do not disturb, Virgo. They need some regeneration time. Some time to recharge. Okay? And think. It's not saying giving up on your goals. Stay committed to them. Okay? They're saying accept the ups and the downs. That's the flow of life. Ride the wave. Wave goes up. Wave comes down. Right? Okay? Go with the flow. Obviously, you're going to see progress if you just stay committed to the task at hand, the goal at hand. Virgo, give me one more for Virgo. One more for Virgo, please. Another for Virgo. My Virgo babies. Ooh, the energy of juggling too much. Like, people is literally, they think this is a fucking circus show, okay? Juggling acts. Like, you can, but why? Why, Virgo? For other people, you taking on all of this? And it's giving me the energy, like, people might have the nerve and the audacity to get irritated or, like, maybe guilt trips or something like that. And you need to be like this, no, and check them if that is the case. It, like, if you don't, the nerve to get irritated and shit like that, if you don't juggle their baggage, their responsibilities. They have you around here like you have, like you're an octopus, okay? With many arms. Juggling act. When you find yourself doing a juggling act, take a break and have an honest look, Virgo. Are you juggling for your own pleasures or creating this show to entertain others? This is the basis of this entire spread here. This card I will put up here for you to see it. You may be really good at multitasking. You probably could take on or have been taking on everybody else's task, whatever, that they could be doing. But why? It's gonna wear you out, burn you down. Why? Okay, at the bottom we have the Thief of Joy. Get into this quickly. Apples to apples comparison. Your highlights to theirs. What use is that? So this could also be the energy, Virgo, of you trying to do so much, like being really competitive, like, okay. So over there, you know, got this going on. You know, they done leveled up. They done accomplished some stuff. And it's like comparing, but you're comparing. You're just as good. It's like apples to apples comparison, literally. Okay? You're a star too. You have the same capability, but you can't burn yourself out. And you have to drop other people's responsibilities and their burdens. Okay? If it's just not for you, so that you can recharge and you can do more for yourself. So apple to apple comparison, your highlights to theirs. What use is that? And for some Virgos, this is somebody trying to compare themselves to you and throwing the evil eye at you because they feel like they don't compare. They have the same 24 hours you do to get their shit done. Okay, same hands and feet and mouth you do, but throwing you the evil eye because they don't go as far as you. It looks like you put in work. You do what you're supposed to do when you're supposed to do it. So deflecting that evil eye energy, protecting yourself spiritually, and continue to do you. So happiness comes from appreciating what's in front of you. Not wishing you were doing something else. All right. Under that is Drama Queen. All right. Let's pull your angel number. We'll wrap this up. I feel like we gotta do the angel insert oracle for you. So you'll be able to ask your question. Let me put it out before I forget, because knowing me. Yeah. For the Cupid of Virgo, let's get your angel number. Let's go with Virgo, please. One more. Virgo. Alright. Virgo. Excuse me, Virgo, please. Some of you literally feel like, I can't stop, I got shit to do. And as a Taurus, I truly understand trying to get to it. But if you continue on like this with this juggling act, you're not going to be good to anyone else or yourself. I love this, Virgo. Okay, hello. 1331, 1331, good fortune. Advice, comfort, major change, individuality, and independence. Have faith in your skills and talents, as they are a tool that can provide you with a bright future. A piece of good advice, a moment of enlightenment, or a comforting message is on its way. This is the message that you need. It's something that you don't understand. And they're telling you, listen, sleep on it. Relax, don't stress yourself. You know, don't overanalyze it. Don't overthink. Don't push too hard when it comes to that. So a piece of good advice, a moment of enlightenment, or a comforting message is on its way for you, Virgo. Everything will work out in your favor. 1331, that's the number combination for you, okay? I love it. The bottom, we have starting over, 101, intelligence, dynamics, making a difference, failures, personal or spiritual development. Happiness is linked to self-expression, growth, and experience. Learning from failures is key. Happiness is real, possible, and around. Understand its process and the pursuit of it. Joy is fluid. It's in the little things and the big ones. Fails are fun. Just start fresh. Okay. Go ahead and get your question in mind, Virgo. Get your question in mind. Get your question in mind. For Virgo. Virgo, please. Thank you. One more good shuffle for Virgo. Alright, my Virgo babies. Some of you guys, this could be around romance. Just saw that at the bottom of the deck. But let's see what comes out. Okay, what message comes out specifically for you, Virgo? Got this crooked one here. Let's see. So we got reconsider. Didn't come out, but it's catching my attention. So I remain positive. I just saw remain positive while I was shuffling. And remain positive comes out. So being stressed to you. It's okay to slow down. It is okay to recover, have some you time, fall down on the couch, put your shit on do not disturb. Okay, that is going to, when you feel burdened and weighed down by too much going on, it's a little, I wouldn't say discouraging, but it's a little hard to remain positive, right? And be in your best self. In the vibration of joy and high energy, because you're damn near burnt out and maybe a little frustrated by how much you have to carry, especially for others. So you know what you got to do, and that's going to aid and assist you in remaining positive and in high vibes. Okay, you can't do it all the time. I'll say it in every reading, impossible, just all success, but remain positive. All right, successful outcomes. Let's get into this remain positive for you. Okay, remain positive, my Virgo babies. Let me go here. Big smile on this angel's face. Bouquet of flowers. Okay. So remain positive. The angels are asking you to keep an optimistic attitude, Virgo. There is a very positive momentum beginning to build towards the creation of your desires. You're speeding in your dreams along by maintaining a cheerful and confident demeanor. Okay, so you're speeding up the process by recovering, taking that downtime for yourself, by being optimistic, still having the joy in your heart, okay? Still shining in a way that's optimistic and somewhat childlike, okay? Just being lighthearted. So you're speeding your dreams along by maintaining a cheerful and confident demeanor. So this is also giving me not a need to physically push yourself to burnout, but to be in that energy of being positive, recharging yourself to speed along that process. It may seem as though your plans are taking a long time to manifest. That's the second time we had that message here, right? But very soon you will see a change. Don't allow yourself to lose hope when your dreams are so close to coming true. Don't let these situations steal your joy. Very, very close to a milestone or achieving something. I'm going to go over this card one more time to stay committed, because this was definitely in alignment with this. Okay, Virgo, stay committed. Your goals may feel so far away that they seem absolutely impossible. Accept the good, the bad, and the in-between times. In the in-between times. Sometimes success takes a little longer to achieve, but it will be yours. So stay committed to your goals at this time. And don't let nobody put too much on your plate. Time for some regeneration, some recovery, some downtime for you. Okay, Virgo? Okay. Success is at the bottom of the deck. I'll see you in the next read.